StoryShot's book summary and review of How Not to Be Wrong, The Power of Mathematical Thinking by Jordan Ellenberg.
Wouldn't you love to never be wrong? You're not alone, and it's hardly a surprise. In our work, relationships, and even our hobbies, we learn from a young age that being wrong is a mistake. Constant correct thinking is a concept that seems almost impossible, right? Wrong, ironically. How Not to Be Wrong by Jordan Ellenberg discusses ways we can make life simpler by thinking mathematically. The book dives into the world of mathematics and explores its applications in everyday life. By looking at simple and complex decisions, Ellenberg reveals our mistaken beliefs that lead to common errors in our thinking. Mathematics is the study of things that come out a certain way because there is no other way they could possibly be. Jordan Ellenberg.
About Jordan Ellenberg.
Jordan Ellenberg is a mathematician and author. He is a professor at the University of Wisconsin-Madison and has written several books on math and its application in various fields. He received his PhD in math from Harvard University in 1998.
StoryShot number one, think in a nonlinear way.
Nonlinear thinking means thinking logically about what you can and cannot control. Consider the following statement: where you should go depends on where you are. This nonlinear way of thinking helps you develop the skill of critical thinking and be better equipped to avoid mistakes. Imagine yourself in a car at a crossroads. When the light turns green, you drive across the road directly in front of you, not diagonally to the opposite side. This is linear thinking. Thinking in a nonlinear way gives us freedom to make choices and move forward with our lives. It also prompts more questions, which leads to more answers. This allows us to acknowledge changes in our lives, even if we have no control over these changes. Linear regression is a statistical technique that looks for a linear relationship between two or more variables. For example, there is a statistic that shows that for every extra $10,000 someone earns, they are 3% more likely to vote Republican. Linear regression can help you understand how different factors influence an outcome and make predictions based on new data.
StoryShot number two. Understand that math is part of everything you do.
Your teachers weren't lying when they said you would use math every day. And you probably aren't even aware of when and how you use it. Calculating the length of your work commute or the budget for a night out, and even the timing of your French press coffee, requires basic math. With this in mind, being right constantly is possible, at least theoretically. If math and its fixed rules are at the heart of everything we do, then following the rules of math should always lead to the correct outcome. This suggests that you can avoid being wrong if you follow these rules step by step. This concept is not naive and provides a sense of comfort in its simplicity. The problem is that people tend to guess and estimate rather than look at the cold, hard facts. This is how mistakes happen, and it's why people are sometimes wrong. If we simplify a problem, it's easier to find an answer. If you take a big problem in your life and break it down, you may find a solution for the simple version that can lead you to an answer for the bigger one. Math is a powerful tool at the heart of almost everything we do. As math is at the forefront of our lives, it is vital to improve our critical reasoning skills. This gives you the chance to be right more often than you're wrong. Through a basic application of simple math, you will arrive at more accurate conclusions, and you can increase your chances of being consistently correct in everything you do.
StoryShot number three. Math can help you win the lottery.
An expected value is the average of the values that a random variable has over many trials. For example, it describes the probability of winning versus losing money in the long run. If you were to visit a casino and play roulette, you could calculate your expected value to inform your decision-making. Consider the probability of winning the lottery and the expected value of lottery tickets. Ellenberg recounts the story of how MIT students managed to win the lottery every time in their town and revisits the law of large numbers, LLN. The students began analyzing well-known lottery games such as Powerball and Mega Millions, but soon became intrigued by cash windfall. The game was designed so that when the jackpot reached $2 million without a winner, it would roll down and be distributed among players who matched fewer numbers. The MIT students used computer software to analyze historical data and predict when roll downs would occur. They exploited a flaw in the game's design by purchasing thousands of tickets during roll downs. Eventually, their scheme was exposed and the game was suspended. Risk can be quantified, but uncertainty cannot. For example, if an urn contains 90 balls, 30 of which are red and the rest yellow and black, the risk of not pulling out a red ball is 2 out of 3. However, it is impossible to quantify the chance of pulling out a black ball. This is the end of part one and the free video shot of How Not to Be Wrong. Thanks for watching. Are you eager to unlock the full potential of your decision-making skills and explore the fascinating world of math? We have the perfect treat for you. Uncover gems like why public opinion doesn't exist and doesn't matter. Explore the depths of knowledge, from the triumph of mediocrity and the common sense behind mathematics to many other captivating insights. It's all within your reach, just a click away. Visit GetStoryShots.com to download our free top-rated app. Join millions of satisfied users as we take you on a growth journey through the best nonfiction books in just minutes, for free. Explore the ultimate destination for the best book summaries, audiobooks, infographics, and other amazing resources, all in one place. Did you like this video? Don't forget to like it, subscribe to our channel, and share it to show you care. See you in the next animated book summary.